Hello everyone, welcome to another series of today's GK. Let's begin with previous day practice question. Question was, Borneo, Java and Sumatra are islands of which of the following archipelagos? Indonesia, Maldives, Mauritius or Seychelles? The correct answer is option A, Indonesia. Indonesia is the largest country in Southeast Asia. Its islands can be grouped into the greater Sunda Islands of Sumatra, Java, the southern extent of Borneo, that is Kalimantan, and Celebes. Hence, option A is correct. Now, let's begin today's session. First question is, consider the following statements with respect to Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. 1. He was part of Gandhi's Salt Satyagraha. 2. His autobiography, India Wins Freedom, was published posthumously in 1959. Which of the above given statement or statements is or are correct? 1 only, 2 only, both 1 and 2, or neither 1 nor 2? The correct answer is option C, both 1 and 2. He was one of the leaders of the Indian independence movement against British rule in the first half of the 20th century. Azad was president of the Congress Party in 1923 and again in 1940-46. He was part of Gandhi's Salt Satyagraha. Hence, statement 1 is correct. His autobiography, India Wins Freedom, was published posthumously in 1959. Hence, statement 2 is also correct. Azad became active in journalism when he was in his late teens, and in 1912, he began publishing a weekly Urdu language newspaper, Al Hilal. Next question is, consider the following statements with reference to PM Cares for Children. 1. It was launched by the Ministry of Social Justice. 2. It aims to support children who have lost both the parents during COVID-19. Which of the above given statement or statements is or are correct? 1 only, 2 only, both 1 and 2, or neither 1 nor 2? The correct answer is option B, 2 only. Honorable Prime Minister of India has announced comprehensive support for children who have lost both their parents to COVID-19. PM Cares for Children launched by Prime Minister on 29th May 2021. Hence, statement 1 is not correct. It aims to support children who have lost both the parents during COVID-19. Hence, statement 2 is correct. Therefore, option B is correct. The objective of the scheme is to ensure comprehensive care and protection of children in a sustained manner and enable their well-being through health insurance, empower them through education, and equip them for self-sufficient existence with financial support on reaching 23 years of age. Next question is, Prevention of Children from Sexual Offences Act, that is POSCO Act, came into force in 2011, 2012, 2013 or 2014. The correct answer is option B, 2012. The Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act 2012, that is POSCO Act 2012, is legislation which aims at protecting children from all types of sexual abuse. Although the Convention on the Rights of the Child was adopted by the United Nations in 1989, the offences against children were not redressed by way of any legislation in India till the year 2012. Prevention of Children from Sexual Offences Act or POSCO Act came into force in 2012. Hence, option B is correct. Next question is, 9th schedule, which was recently in news, was added in the Constitution by which Constitutional Amendment Act? 1st Constitutional Amendment Act, 2nd, 3rd or 4th? The correct answer is option A, 1st Constitutional Amendment Act. The 9th schedule contains a list of central and state laws which cannot be challenged in courts. Currently, 284 such laws as of 14 November 2022 are shielded from judicial review. Most of the laws protected under the schedule concern agriculture or land issues. It was added in the Constitution, was added by the 1st Constitutional Amendment Act. Hence, option A is correct. Next question is, consider the following pairs. Lunar Mission and Space Agency. 1. Chandrayaan 2, ISRO. 2. Apollo 11, NASA. 3. Artemis 1, JAXA. Which of the pairs given above is or are correctly matched? 1 only, 1 and 3 only, 1 and 2 only, or 1, 2 and 3? The correct answer is option C, 1 and 2 only. Chandrayaan 2 mission is a highly complex mission which represents a significant technological leap compared to the previous missions of ISRO. It comprised an orbiter, lander and rover to explore the unexplored south pole of the moon. Apollo 11 was the culmination of the Apollo program and a massive national commitment by the United States to beat the Soviet Union in putting people on the moon. Artemis 1 is an ongoing uncrewed moon orbiting mission, the first space flight in NASA's Artemis program. Hence, option C is correct. Next question is, recently ASEAN was in news. Where is its headquarters? Dhaka, Jakarta, Kuala Lumpur or Bangkok? The correct answer is option B, Jakarta. The Association of Southeast Asian Nations or ASEAN was established on 8th August 1967 in Bangkok, Thailand with the signing of the ASEAN Declaration, that is also known as Bangkok Declaration. The headquarters of ASEAN is Jakarta, Indonesia. Hence, option B is correct. It is an intergovernmental organization that has 10 member countries in Southeast Asia, Brunei, Cambodia, Indonesia, Laos, Malaysia, Myanmar, the Philippines, Singapore, Thailand, and Vietnam. Next question is, recently G20 Trioka was in news. The countries in current G20 Trioka as of 21st November 2022 are Italy, Indonesia, India, Italy, Japan, India, Russia, US, India, or Japan, US, India. The correct answer is option A, Italy, Indonesia, and India. The G20 or Group of 20 is an intergovernmental forum comprising 19 countries and the European Union. It works to address major issues related to the global economy, such as international financial stability, climate change mitigation, and sustainable development. The presidency of the G20 rotates every year among its members, with the country that holds the presidency working together with its predecessor and successor, also known as Trioka, to ensure the continuity of the agenda. Currently, Italy, Indonesia, and India are the Trioka countries. Hence, option A is correct. It has no permanent secretariat. Agenda and the work coordination are completed by G20 leaders' personal representatives known as Sherpas together with finance ministers and central bank governors. Next question is, in which case Supreme Court propounded for the first time basic structure of the constitution? I.R. Coelho versus State of Tamil Nadu, Keswananda Bharti case, S.R. Bommai case or Menaka Gandhi case? The correct answer is option B, Keswananda Bharti case. On 24th April 1973, in Keshwananda Bharti case, Supreme Court propounded for the first time the basic structure of the Constitution. The Supreme Court pronounced on April 24, 1973, by a razor-thin majority of 7:6, that although Parliament had the power to amend any part of the Constitution of India, it could not use this power to alter or destroy the basic structure of the Constitution. Hence, option B is correct. Next question is, Myanmar shares borders with 1 China, 2 Laos, 3 India, 4 Bangladesh. Select the correct answer using the code given below. 1, 2 and 4 only, 1, 2 and 3 only, 1, 3 and 4 only, or 1, 2, 3 and 4. The correct answer is option D, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Recently, United Nations Chief Antonio Guterres on Saturday urged the Myanmar junta to immediately restart democracy, saying it was the only way to stop the unending nightmare engulfing the country. Myanmar's military regime has extended its emergency rule until 2023 following last year's coup. The country is bordered by China to the north and northeast, Laos to the east, Thailand to the southeast, the Andaman Sea and Bay of Bengal to the south and southwest, Bangladesh to the west, and India to the northwest. Hence, option D is correct. Last question is, which of the following conference of parties or COP is not correctly matched? COP and venue, COP24 Poland, COP25 Madrid, COP26 Glasgow, or COP27 Paris? The correct answer is option D, COP27 Paris. The Conference of Parties or COP is the apex decision-making body of the United Nations Climate Change Framework Convention, that is UNFCCC. The UNFCCC was formed in 1994 to stabilize the greenhouse gas emissions and to protect the Earth from the threat of climate change. COP members have been meeting every year since the year 1995. As of 2019, the number of member countries in the UNFCCC has reached 197. The first conference, that is COP1, was held in 1995 in Berlin, COP24 was held on 3 to 14th December 2018 in Katowice, Poland. COP25 was held in Madrid, Spain. COP26 was held in Glasgow, Scotland. COP27 is scheduled to be held in Sharm el-Sheikh, Egypt from 6 November 2022 to 18th November 2022. Hence, option D is not correctly matched. Now it's time for the practice question. Which of the following countries is not associated with ASEAN, that is Association of Southeast Asian Nations? Myanmar, Indonesia, Brunei or South Korea? Send the answer of this question in the comment section. Stay tuned for the next episode. Thanks for watching.